Father, hear our prayers today as we unite as one. You are a God of compassion, a God of dignity, and a God of strength. And I pray, O Lord, that you watch over the veterans of these, the United States of America. In recognition of their loyal service to our nation, bless them with their wholeness and their love. Shelter them, heal their wounds, comfort their hearts, and grant them peace. You are a God of justice and truth. You are the rock in our lives. And Heavenly Father, I turn to you and I ask that you bless our veterans, these men and women of courage and valor. Bless them with a deep and abiding understanding of our profound gratitude. May their dedication and honor be remembered as a blessing from generation to generation. Blessed are you, Father, our protector, our redeemer, our shield, and our stronghold. Lord, we pray for our veterans, the veterans who have sacrificed, who served, and have made this country proud and made this country safe. I pray for the homegrown heroes who were on the front lines where fear and fate intercepted. I pray for the veterans on the military bases, the veterans who served in the hospitals, the classrooms, or in the offices. I pray for the veterans who staffed an embassy or who guarded our leaders. I pray for those who are continuing to serve today. Wherever and wherever they've been called to serve, we are in their debt. Lord, I thank you for this bold and open-hearted nation. For this bold and open-hearted leaders who protected our lives of precious liberty. Thank you for the veterans who gave us freedom, doing battle for our rights, upholding the values of this country. And today, Father, we stand here and we give you praise to give them the courage that you instilled in them and ask that you continue to bless these bold and open-hearted veterans that have served and continue to serve in our country. Amen.
I'm listening to the ceremony because I thought that's what you guys were doing as well. So I'm right across the street at Grape Park, right in front of the band. So the band's about to play.
I want to make sure that all the veterans in attendance here have a flag. We have them here in the front. There'll be a couple of ladies walking around.
Hang tight, because sure if you want to cross over, you can come back over here. Or just
at this time,
stay there.
The Milford High School Marching Band will begin the medley of hymns. Veterans, please raise your flag when your hymn is played. Nadine, Jody, take it away.
Thank you.
Milford and the Salvation Army, we want to thank each and every veteran for your service.
How'd you get this?
We want to thank the band leaders, Nadine Pomeroy, Director of Music, Jill Baudet, Assistant Band Director. Thank you. And now we have Miss Sophia McClay to sing the national anthem.
So gallantly streaming, and the rockets regular, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled
that's our granddaughter. Now I'll hand it over to Chairman of the Milford Board of Selectmen, Mr. Bill Buckley.
Thank you, Peter. First of all, I want to thank the veterans of Vietnam who are celebrating their 50th year return. They never got the parade they were entitled to. But we certainly wish you well, and thank you for your service. I also want to thank all the veterans that are here. My father was a veteran. He was what they called a lifer. He spent a career in the military, and we traveled around the globe with him. We learned as a family how important it was to help support the veterans and their families. Father Mateus said, think of the families of our veterans as well as the veterans. Very, very important. He also said something very profound that stuck to me. He asked God to grant the veterans peace, a peace greater than the veterans have provided us. That stuck out to me. I want to thank the citizens of Milford who put this together, who thought of a field of flags, another way to honor our veterans, honor our country. We are in deep gratitude to our veterans. I want to say on behalf of the Board of Selectmen, my colleagues, on behalf of a very grateful nation and a very grateful community, thank you for all that you've done in helping us to be here today and to be able to honor you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Bill. And now to lead off with comments about his honoree, Father Mateo of the St. Mary's Parish. Father?
Thank you so much. I'm really glad to be here tonight, today, especially for my dear friend, Stanley Bukowski. I had a chance to meet him over a countryside nursing home. So we became very good friends. He shared with me not only his story, but also the pains. So thank you so much, Stanley, for being here with us today. We love you very much. We love our veterans, all men and women who helped to protect this country, which we love very much. So today we ask the blessing of God upon us, upon you guys, all those who are already at God's arms. And we'd like to ask always the peace for you, for your hearts. And thank you so much. We are very proud of you. So again, we're gonna give you a round of applause. Thank you so much for all your work. And we thank God for having us here today. We thank you so much. God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Father. Now I'll ask the sponsors, whoever's interested in saying a few words, please come forward and the mic is yours.
Citizens and visitors and guests, and especially our veterans. My name is Mary Ann Soligan, and my late husband, Peter Soligan, served in the U.S. Army in the Armor Division. He was a captain, and he served in Vietnam in armor. But what I really want to say is thank you to all the veterans. The Vietnam era was definitely a forgotten era. Good news with Vietnam, if there was such a thing, if we knew the tour of duty, at least at the time, was 12 months. Those veterans who served in World War II never knew when they were coming home until the war was over. The Korean veterans also had a very rough time, as have all the veterans since the beginning of time. We want to say thank you. And veterans, to be honored, does not mean what rank you are in or what branch you're in. You still serve this country with honor, and we want to say thank you for that. Last year, I went to my husband's 50th college reunion at Niagara University, and we had a hard time convincing the administration and the alumni office that we needed to honor the veterans. And this year was my 50th, and they set up for 100 people, and people were still standing. So they're starting to, the middle generation didn't quite realize how much Vietnam meant and how it affected all our lives. And besides the veterans, it also affected the families that are home. It affected the spouses and the children whose parent was overseas or away. So thank you very much for all you've done, for all you do, and let us keep the current service men and women in our prayers and hope wish them safety and a safe return. God bless each of you and God bless America.
Thank you. Somebody else like to come up? Anybody else would like to say a few words about the honoree?
I think what Mary Ann said is just beautiful. We were very proud to sponsor a flag for my cousin Al Sullivan, who served in Korea, who's now in the arms of God, and a flag for his brother, my cousin John Sullivan, who is still suffering the effects of Agent Orange from Vietnam. Please keep all our veterans in your thoughts and prayers. They have done so much for us. It's the very least we can do.
They were the troops that were buried in the caves in Japan that the Japanese took as hostages. And he said that the men that came back were so emaciated that it was sickening, but they got the best of care on the ship and came back safe and sound. Thank you.
Someone else like to come up and say a few words.
Good morning. My flag is for my father, Nicholas Di Maria, who is private first class in World War II. He's 92 years old, and I thank God every day that he instilled in his children a love for their country and patriotism. Thank you.
Anyone else, please come up. Well, I'd like to take this opportunity to mention something about Claudia's dad, Rocco Morelli. He's an old local family. Enlisted at the age of 21 during World War II, landed on Omaha Beach during the second wave. There was sporadic gunfire, but he made it over the beach to the little town of San Lo, and that's where he was wounded. His wounds were life-threatening, and he ended up within Walter Reed Army Hospital at Gangrene. Lost half his body weight, but survived, and when he returned to Milford, few people could recognize him. I'm sure there was more to Rocky's story, but he never talked about the war. Little we know is from Claudia's memories. All right, if there's no one else, then I think we're just going to recite the name of everyone who sponsored the flag here. The honoree, rather. Right?
I'd like to begin with Raymond Osier, Donald Lee Bernard, Stanley Bukowski, Louis Bondino, Anthony Buckley, John Dulcher, William Castrucci Jr., Joseph Sirmacoli, Vincent Fazzari, William Curbelo Jr., Donald V. DeLorme Sr., Nicholas D. Maria, Edward DeMichel, Patrick DeMichel, Roger Patrick Dugan, and Harvey Ellis.
Luigi Galante, John J. Green, Marvin Greenman, William Griffith, Anthony M. Guarino Sr., Salvatore R. Galino, Bruce Harding, William Harding Jr., William Harding, Leo J. Harlow, Paul Carrera, Alfred
Woodrow Malnati, Frederick I. Mitchell, Jack Mogul, Rocco P. Morelli, Harold V. Murphy, Jr., Ariana C. Nero, Daniel A. Nero, Donato Nero, Leo Oliveri, William B. Palmer, Carmen J. Pilla, Frank R. Perello, Jr., Joseph E. Redden Sr., Michael W. Reese.
J. Richards, Richard Reinhardt, Angelo J. Rigardi, Edward Robertson, Carl A. Romagnoli, Albert J. Romano Jr., Deacon Roland F. Rugoletti, Raymond Frank Sanchez, Edward J. Saracen, Alphonse L. Scandoni, Dominic L. Scotomeglia, Thomas H. Seaver, Irving D. Smith, Joseph D. Soares, Peter P. Soligan, William C. Stacy, and Robert Stedman.
Michael Stone, Chris Michael Stone, Alfred C. Sullivan, John D. Sullivan, Timothy R. Sullivan, Francis R. Sr. Tebow, Stephen J. Treadle, Matthew A. Benziano, Jr., Matthew A. Benziano, Sr., John A. Villani, John Patrick Villani, Michael P. Visconti, Joan Weinkoff, Fred Weinkoff, Jeremiah Young, and Pasquale M. Zampino. Okay, now I'll turn this over to Steve Treadle, our co-chairman of Citizens for Milford. Love those flags.
As a veteran myself, I deeply appreciate all of those who have sponsored a flag to make this event possible. It's so uplifting to know that you haven't forgotten us. There's some very special, humble, and hardworking people who worked long hours to organize this event, to get the information on the honorees. Many phone calls were necessary and set up this heartwarming display of flags. I want you to meet them. Please raise your hand when I call your name so we can all see who you are and thank you. Peter Scandone, his wife Claudia, Jerry with Jerry. Beverly, Nancy, Kim, Rosemary, Maria, and Major Dave Irwin. After we're done here, we invite you to walk through the display of flags. They are organized by alphabetical order, going counterclockwise around the perimeter of the park, starting at the park entrance opposite us. We also want you to be aware that our hometown radio station, WMRC, has volunteered to honor one of our flag honorees during this celebration of America segment each morning. So each morning they're going to honor one of these honorees. And finally, we want you to know that Citizens for Milford will be sponsoring this event together with the Salvation Army every year. It's our dream to fill this entire park with our precious flags and the memories of our veterans that they represent. Each year, they will stand tall here on five patriotic holidays: Veterans Day, Memorial Day, Flag Day, 4th of July, and Labor Day. Please spread the word to your friends about this wonderful and meaningful opportunity to show the world that we here in Milford value those who have and are still serving. You can get right on it, in on this year of honor right now. We have 6 flags without sponsors available, and you can also sponsor additional flags for the remaining 4 days of display. You just see Nancy over here. Okay, we have one final song from our band, a very important and meaningful song.
Big a pen.